Everybody, I'm here today to tell you what to do if your gas pedal sticks. Basically, if you can't stop accelerating, these are the steps that you should take if you want to have a safe and a positive outcome at the end of the situation. I'm going to tell you some simple steps. Hopefully, this never happens to you, but unfortunately, it happens all the time to people. So if it happens to you, you got to know what to do. I rhyme all the time. All right, let's get right into the video. The first step is to shift into neutral. Now, if your gas pedal is sticking down and you can't stop accelerating, whether it's completely down like it's flooring it or just accelerating a little bit, then you want to shift into neutral, because if the car's in drive, which I'm assuming that it is, or in a certain gear, then it's going to continue to accelerate at higher and higher speeds. But if you put it into neutral, it will rev, but the car speed is not going to continue rising. And remember, in a manual car, use the clutch. And I'm reminding you of this because when you're nervous, if this happens, when your nerves kick in, you forget things. So remember to use the clutch to pop it into neutral. Sometimes people are like, it won't go in neutral, it won't go in neutral in a manual car, and it's because they forgot to push the clutch in because they're nervous in a situation like this. Step number two is apply the brakes. Now, I'm assuming that your brakes work, and hopefully they do. Hopefully it's just your gas pedal that's affected. But basically, you want to apply the brakes, so you want to start to brake. No need to slam your brakes unless you have to avoid an accident in front of you, but apply your brakes. Step number three is put on your hazards to warn other drivers, okay? Even if you're smoothly bringing your car off the road right now, you still are experiencing some car trouble and you wanna warn other drivers, okay? You want to warn other drivers of this, because let's say things don't go as planned and you don't make it off the road. Now you got like 30 cars behind you wondering why you just stopped in the middle of the road. Whereas if you put your hazards on, they're going to know in advance, oh, something's wrong with this car in front of me. Let me get out of the way. Let me give them some space. People are more likely to give you some extra room to move if you put your hazards on. Step number four is keep your eyes focused like lasers on the road. You want to have laser focus, okay? And that's simply because I know that you're scared, you're nervous, you're looking, but focus. You don't want to rear end someone. You know, you popped it into neutral, you can brake now. You don't want to like let your lack of focus cause the accident instead of your gas pedal sticking. So keep your eyes focused on the road. Sorry, I'm going to turn that air down. It's really hot in here, but the air is going to be way too loud for the video. Keep your eyes focused on the road, okay? Step number five is to steer the car off of the road if possible. If you're able to actually get off of the road, you want to do that. So steer into a parking lot, maybe onto a side street or onto the shoulder of the highway. Whatever the case is, you want to get it away from traffic so that you can do whatever you need to get the car turned off and get some help, okay? So basically, if it's possible for you to steer the car off the road, go for it. If not, if you can't steer it off the road, then just come to a stop with your hazards on in the lane, because you have no other option, okay? That was step number five, steer the car off the road if possible. Step number six is turn off the car. So take your ignition key, turn it off, or take the push button start, turn the car off. And you'll hear the revs drop down to nothing, which is good. It'll put you at ease. And then step number seven is going to be engage the emergency brake. So you're going to want to put your emergency brake on, and I'll tell you exactly why. Because if you can't shut the car off, and you try and shift into park, then I'll tell you exactly what's going to happen. Let's say you can't shut the car off and you try and shift the car into park. Well, you're going to go from neutral past reverse while the gas pedal is going. So it's probably going to send you flying back. If you can shut the car off, then put it in park, because then the engine has been stopped. You can go ahead and put it in park. But if you can't shut the car off, then you're going to want to have the emergency brake on. And regardless, you want to have the emergency brake on, because if your gas pedal is sticking, that means there's a problem with the car. You don't know if there's any other problems with the car. So just engage your emergency brake and you have an extra form of support that is keeping your car from just driving off and flooring it, okay? And then you want to call for help and get it fixed. I mean, you can look like maybe there's just something there that's causing it to stay depressed, the pedal to stay depressed and pressed down, right? Maybe that's the case. And if that's the case, just hopefully you can maybe just remove that object and fix it yourself. Maybe there's like a pen that's stuck between the gas pedal and the top of the, you know, the thing underneath the steering wheel. It's like holding it down. I don't know. I just said that because I actually have a pen over here. But you get the idea, right? I mean, this could be technically, if this is the gas pedal and my finger is the top of the bottom of the dash, it could just be pushing down on the pedal. And that's possible, but if not, then call for professional help and get your car towed to a mechanic shop and have them look at it and hopefully fix it. And that's it. That's what to do if your gas pedal sticks. Basically, if you can't stop accelerating, that is what you have to do. And that's it. If you like this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up. Let me know what you think down below as a comment. And of course, be sure to subscribe for more great car and driving videos just like this one. And that's all I have for you today. Thanks for watching.